What is it that you really think Cisco can offer a world in which AI agents are going to be running left, right and center?
Caroline, it's good to see you again. Thank you for having me on the show. Look, if you take a step back, we are probably witnessing one of the most seismic shifts that we've seen in humanity with AI. And we are now squarely in the second phase of AI, where you're moving from these chatbots that intelligently answered questions to agents that are going to conduct tasks and jobs almost fully autonomously to automate workflows. Now, as that happens, you know, we start to think about, like, what are the constraints and impediments that might actually really limit the growth of AI? And we think there are three big constraints. First one is infrastructure, where you just don't have enough power, compute, networking, bandwidth to go out and, you know, sort of satiate the demand for AI.
Yeah.
The second is a trust deficit, where if you don't trust these systems, you're not going to use them. And so you have to make sure that the safety and security is really well thought through. And the third one is a data gap. And in all these three areas, Splunk actually plays a pretty big role. We happen to be at the user conference of Splunk in Boston, and we've just made some pretty amazing announcements around what we're going to be able to do specifically around machine data and AI. Like, so far, AI has been really good with human data and training models on human, kind of human-generated data that's publicly available on the internet. What they've not been as good at is machine data.
Yeah.
And so what we want to do is make sure that we can actually have the time series machine data also be used to train these models. And we're excited about all the innovations that we've had so far.
I mean, Jeetu, as the product innovator here, how is it that you, what is the technological feats that you have to do working alongside Splunk? What is it that you have to drive that's different from others?
Now, I feel like that formula is pretty simple, Caroline. It's like, you know, in tech, you just have to be relentlessly obsessed about continuing to innovate and making sure that you keep listening to customers and creating solutions that are at least an order of magnitude better than what's available in the market. No one switches to you for 10% better. You have to be at least an order of magnitude better. And so we have this rule internally called be 10x better, and you're going to actually make sure the customers will get excited. And we saw that level of palpable energy today and at the event, where all of our customers were just completely excited about the machine data lake announcement we made. We made an announcement around an open source model for time series data. These are all really hard problems that actually require a level of assistance so that organizations can harness the full potential of AI because of the way that they can use data.
Jeetu, is there evidence that Splunk's historic customers are using Cisco's other products and signing on for deals on that side and vice versa since you guys have closed?
We've actually seen a lot of great evidence around it. In fact, just last quarter, we closed, one of the large financial services organizations that happened to be a great Cisco customer is also a Splunk customer. And we replaced another competitor in that account with Splunk. And let me tell you the reason why. If you really think about where Splunk shines is correlating data across multiple different sources. And if you start thinking about the kind of data that we have, if you assume that the attacker is already in your network, and what you're trying to do is prevent lateral movement, who has the most amount of data about the network? Cisco does. The telemetry from that network, hydrating Splunk, actually gives Splunk meaningful insights. The telemetry from users and devices and the security firewalls that we might have, all of these pieces add value to Splunk. So what ends up happening is customers, when they're starting to use Cisco technology with Splunk, actually find them to not only be able to derive insights that were not able to be derived before, but you also get to be very economical in the way that you use it. And we made this one big announcement around Cisco firewall telemetry getting ingested in Splunk for free. And so that actually provides incentives from a financial perspective to our customers as well.
Jeetu, when I speak to industry, they say it's you personally that's responsible for bringing Cisco into this AI era. So very quickly to end, I wanted to ask where you feel Cisco is today versus where you want it to be in 3 to 5 years' time now that Splunk's being integrated.
Well, let me just start by saying that it is not just me. There's a wonderful team of people behind me that do all the work, and so I'm just lucky to be a small part of it. Where we see AI, moving forward is we are now squarely in the second phase, and we're helping companies out with massive data center buildouts, whether it be hyperscalers or neoclouds or service providers or the enterprise. And the fact that we serve all those four constituencies helps each one of the constituencies from the learnings that we get from each one of them. So that's the first area that we're really helping in a big way. And, you know, low latency, high performance, energy efficient networking is one of our core value propositions there. Second, we're really helping with making sure that AI is safe and secure. And by the way, what I mean by that is not just using AI for security, but securing AI itself. That's a really, really important area that we've got a tremendous amount of offerings that are helping customers out. And the third one is this notion of, if 55% of the growth of data is coming from machine data, and the market has not really gone out and figured out how to use machine data effectively with AI, that's the problem that we want to solve. And that's where we've actually made these announcements with Splunk. And so the combination of those three technologies coming together in a unified platform is where we can really shine. And very few companies in the world have the level of breadth and depth of technology that we do. So we feel pretty fortunate about that.